39 class. Today we will revise the chapter number system. Children, today we will discuss about how to rationalize irrational numbers under the topic number system. First of all, let me take some examples. Children, here irrational number is 1 upon root 2. If I want to rationalize this number, then what I have to do? I have to multiply both numerator and denominator with this root 2 because it is the denominator of this number. So I multiply this root 2 in numerator and denominator both. You can see here, if I multiply 1 by this root 2, I get root 2. And when I multiply root 2 by this root 2, as you know, by the rules of multiplication of radicals, root 2 multiply by root 2 becomes 2. So here this root 2 upon 2, our required answer. Children, let me take another example. Here there is another number, 1 upon 2 plus root 3. If I want to rationalize this number, then I have to multiply both numerator and denominator by the conjugate of this number. Conjugate means, if there is 2 plus root 3, then I have to multiply it by 2 minus root 3. I have to just change the sign of this number. Here it is 2 plus root 3 and I have taken 2 minus root 3. If children, if there was minus sign, then we can replace it by positive sign. And if there is positive sign, then we can change it by negative sign. So I am to multiply this 2 minus root 3 in both numerator and denominator. Now children, multiply this 1 by this 2 minus root 3, then we get 2 minus root 3 here. And if I multiply 2 plus root 3 by 2 minus root 3, you can see that here it becomes an identity like a plus b, a minus b, and the identity of a plus b, a minus b, as you know, it is a square minus b square. So children, a square becomes 2 square and root 3 square, here it comes. So now we can solve it further. 2 minus root 3, we can write it as it is. And when I solve this denominator, then this 2 square becomes 4 and this root 3 square becomes 3. Children, now solve it further. This 2 minus root 3 remains as it is. And when I subtract 3 from 4, I get 1. So here our denominator comes 1. So children, I can also write this number as 2 minus root 3. So this is the required solution of this question. Children, we can take another example. Here there is another question, 1 upon 7 plus 3 root 2. I want to rationalize this number. So as we have discussed earlier, children, we are to multiply this number by the conjugate, and the conjugate we get by just changing this sign. So here it is positive sign, so I have taken here negative sign. So I multiply this 1 upon 7 plus 3 root 2 by 7 minus 3 root 2 in both numerator and denominator. Children, here you must just keep in your mind that when you multiply by and conjugate any number, then you should multiply both numerator and denominator. Now solve it further. When you multiply this numerator 7 minus 3 root 2 by 1, you get 7 minus 3 root 2. And when you multiply these both denominators, you can again see here that here it becomes an identity of a plus b, a minus b. And the identity of a plus b and a minus b is a square minus b square. So now children, if we want to solve it, the 7 square becomes 49 and this 3 root 2 square becomes 18. You can also solve this 3 root 2 square like this. If I want to solve this 3 root 2 square, then now I have to multiply this 3 root 2 by 3 root 2. So how we can solve it? First of all, multiply this 3 by 3. So now multiply and multiply this root 2 by this root 2. So multiply root 2 by root 2. When you multiply 3 by 3, then 3 threes are becomes 9. 9 and when you multiply this root 2 by this root 2, it becomes 2 and 9 2s becomes 18. So children, this is our rough work and so we can write 3 root 2 square here 18. Now we can solve it further by subtracting 18 from 49. So subtract it and you get here 31 and our numerator remains as it is. So children, our final answer is 7 minus 3 root 2 upon 31. So children, keep on practicing at your home. We will continue it. Thank you.